Building performance engines does obviously require some specialist tools, and one of the problems is finding and sourcing the particular tools that you need for a particular engine. This can be really difficult to achieve. We're here with Tom from Hughes Race Built to talk about his solution to that exact problem. Now, Tom, for a start, when you're building specific engines, often there are manufacturers' special service tools, and you can possibly buy those from the manufacturer. So why isn't that a viable solution for most enthusiasts?
A lot of JDM engines don't have that support. And seeing where the engine builders, we deal with this every day, we don't have those tools available. So we thought, why not build tools to suit JDM engines that you can't buy?
So you're actually selling a complete essential engine building tool set for particular engine models?
Yep. So we're breaking down the JDM models. I started with the JZ and the RB, which is a model we know really, really well. And then we're going to branch out from SR, 4Gs, all the Honda K series, B series. We've got full build kits. We break the toolkits down so you can buy the tools individually. Generic engine building kits from ballastman compressors, balancer pullers. Everything. Everything we can cover the full range to make it as easy as possible for anyone building a JDM engine to get the job done.
To be clear, this is not every single tool that you need to build an engine. You're still going to need a socket set, for example, correct?
Yeah. So these are specialized tools to do certain jobs within the engine. We do this every day, so we understand these engines very well. So giving the opportunity for enthusiasts or people who might aspire to build an engine, this might be the final kind of nudge they need to buy the tools, do it themselves, and start the process.
All right, let's talk through some of the specifics of the tools that you're offering. And I don't necessarily need to focus on a particular engine here, but I've had a look through what you're offering. One of the problems often is, let's say we want to remove the front pulley, the harmonic damper, for example, and that can be problematic. The crank bolt is often tied into a very high torque level, so it's difficult to undo that. How do you deal with that?
So we have engine lockup kits for each brand. So that can be from locking the engine stand up or locking the crank up on the engine stand, locking the crank in car in place through the starter motor hole, or locking the engine ring gear against the back of the bell housing face. So that helps if you're trying to undo the crank bolt in place, you're trying to torque flywheel. And then if you need to pull the balancer off, we have a hydraulic balancer puller kit, which makes the job so easy. It's got all the bolts you need. It's actually a massive game changer because sometimes that process becomes way too hard for what you're trying to do.
Now, I've absolutely been here myself with removing dampers. They are tricky. I'm just interested if you could maybe explain the principle behind a hydraulic puller, how that actually works.
Yep, so it runs a 12-ton hydraulic ram, which goes through the balancer puller plate, and that pushes up against the front of the crank, allowing you to basically wind the balancer off with one hand, and it'll pull the balancer off no matter how tight it is. Super safe to use. It's got adapters for every kind of crank size, from like a big block all the way down to a 4H. Something everyone battles with, and being that the kit's got all the bolts you need, it's got all the adapters, makes it super easy to use.
All right, so let's move on to some of the other tools. Now, another one that I've noticed in your tool set is your ring compressor. Now, conventionally, the sort of universal option is sort of a ring compressor that can be sort of tightened up to deal with just about any piston or bore size. I've used these myself. Yes, they do work, but they can be problematic, I find, particularly if you're not very careful with them. It can be possible to have the ring pop out as it's entering the bore, and then if you don't notice, it's easy to damage a ring or, in a worst case, even scratch up the bore. On the other hand, we have tapered ring compressors, which are essentially CNC machined out of aluminium, and these are great, almost impossible to damage a ring, but then you have to have one for each specific bore size. You've kind of got the best of both worlds. Can you explain how your ring compressors work?
Yeah, conventional ring compressors are super dangerous in my mind. I do not like using them. So to kind of go between having to buy, like you said, multiple bore sizes, but if you're an RB guy or JZ guy, you got an 86 mil bore, you might want the option to go 86 stock, you might be half mil over, or you might be 87 mil. So we've kind of combined the both of them. It's an adjustable billet ring sleeve. So it can do from 86 to 87 mil. It'll cover the range. You just need one compressor to do the whole job, meaning you don't have to go, like you said, and buy multiple ring sleeves.
So you're covering the ring size or bore size options that you're conventionally going to come up with for a particular engine. So you only need one product instead of potentially three.
Yeah, exactly that.
All right, the next pet hate for me is valve spring compressors. These are kind of problematic, and I've got a universal valve spring compressor that requires a huge amount of effort when you're installing and removing valve springs. I find it really clumsy. Again, if you're not careful with it, it's possible to potentially do some damage to maybe the deck surface of the cylinder head, or you know, maybe the combustion chamber, maybe other things. How does your solution work?
Yep, so we've based it around the body of a conventional ring compressor, but we've added a quarter inch drive, so you can use a quarter inch drive drill or impact driver. You can also still use like a quarter inch drive T to drive it if you don't have that. We've made everything bronze bush, it moves freely, it's all billet. It's really nice to hold and use, and we're really stoked with it. And we've developed it over the last probably 5 years since I started the business. We've always had one of these in-house, but now we've got the tool line, we can bring these tools out that we've made for ourselves.
Is it safe to say, essentially, you're now creating the tools that you, as an engine builder, have either been using at a specialist or have wanted to have access to that didn't exist on the market?
Yeah, giving people access to the tools that we've had in-house is going to be what we're all about. Giving it to the enthusiasts, the aspiring engine builder, and giving them option to have trick tools that work well and look awesome in the workshop.
I guess the obvious next question is, can you give us an idea of price point? I'm going to guess here this will depend on the specific engine tool set that you're looking at, but can you give us a ballpark here?
Yeah, so we're trying to make the tools accessible for everyone. Like a full engine build kit to do a JZ, RB or SR will be around the $1,000 mark. That gives you all the specialised tools you need to work on that engine.
I mean, this is going to make a lot of sense for those who are maybe planning on building multiple engines. That's a no-brainer. But even at that price point, for those who are maybe building their own engine as a one-off, when you start adding up all of the components and parts that you're going to put into that engine, it's still not out of the ballpark, I wouldn't think.
No, it's there for those people who are right on the point of maybe considering doing their own build, and this should be enough to get them over the line and get them excited.
One thing I would point out as well, usually, even if you're an enthusiast building your own engine, it's usually not a one and done sort of situation. These engines do require freshen up, so that tool set, even for the average enthusiast doing their own engine, is still going to get used multiple times. If people want to find out more or purchase, where are they best to do so?
Go to hughesracebuilt.com. All the products we have there released are online. Check out our social medias. Yeah.
And for those watching, I am absolutely going to be purchasing these kits for our own in-house use, because this is something that I've really seen a gap in the market for, and I've really struggled with myself. So great that you are bringing out such a thoroughly developed product that really does fill a hole in the market. Thanks again.
Appreciate it.
If you like that video, make sure you give it a thumbs up. And if you're not already a subscriber, make sure you're subscribed. We release a new video every week. And if you like free stuff, we've got a great deal for you. Click the link in the description to claim your free spot to our next live lesson.